Okay, so I'm here to talk about combining lab and art, because that's something I'm really interested in doing. No? Yes. I think there's a lot of really interesting things for lab designers to get from art. Some of the things I'm really interested in is the way art uses abstract elements and sensory influences and sometimes movement, and the way that art can create intuitive, meaningful experiences. And I think a lot of artists are becoming interested in lab as well. And I think this makes a lot of sense. Is that okay? Cool. I think this makes a lot of sense because we are getting really, really good at what we are doing. We are really good at making experience design and interaction design. And like lab itself, what we're creating is a frame where you can do anything, but people come and live there, truthfully living up to the fiction or the circumstances that you had created. And this is such a powerful tool, as Lucas said, to explore anything. Like, we can explore what it's like to have a different gender or different power structure or any kind of themes or what it's like to move in a different way. Like, we can do anything with this. What I want to talk about now, though, is lab as art. So playable labs presented as an art piece for an audience. Yeah, thank you. It sounds weird, right?
That might help.
Yeah?
Let's try that. Yeah.
Cool. This sounds better, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. Nice. Okay. So, I think lab actually can be really watchable. Not all labs are, because not all labs are meant to be watchable. But again, because we have this wonderful frame that we can do anything with, we can, of course, make players move or interact in interesting ways. And lab has this quality when you watch it, which is different from, for example, theater and dance. And that is that labers are not performing for anyone. They are living through an experience. And that can be really beautiful to watch if you know what you're looking for. So if you're making labs for an audience, of course you have to frame it in a way so they know why this is so interesting to see. But again, it is really doable. And another thing that you can do with lab, I think, is to make the audience interact or influence the lab that you're creating. Because lab is like improvised and you have this frame that you can do anything with, it's easy to find places where an audience can come in and meaningfully again influence the lab or interact with the labers. No? Yeah? Nice. And from a lab's perspective, I think an audience can also do very interesting things. You interact with an audience member in another way than you would with another laber, because you're in your fiction and your character, and the audience, if they're not playing, are themselves from their reality. And making these two worlds meet can be really interesting. It has this weird fragile negotiation where you're both like entering a bit into the other's field, and it can be really awkward if you're not doing it right, but it can also be really beautiful. And being watched as a larper larping is something I'm personally enjoying a lot. In the beginning, I've played several audience inclusive larps, either with a present audience or something being filmed, and in the beginning it was hard not to perform for the audience. But when I learned to relax, I found that knowing that someone is watching me is really nice, because you get things feel important, because you know someone is out there and looking at you, living with you through your personal experiences, and also judging all that you do as part of an art piece. And even though it might not influence my play directly, knowing this makes some difference, which I really like. Yes. So if you're designing a lab as an art piece, there's some things to be attentive to. One of them is that you're creating two things at the same time. You're creating an art piece for an audience and a lab for a group of labers. And the design strategies and the purpose for these two things are not necessarily the same. Even like if you're having the labers, the audience members play your lab, they might come with a different set of expectations than labers normally would. Like having a more aesthetic experience, like experiencing art. And either you have to meet those expectations, or you have to tell the audience that they are having another kind of experience than they're expecting. I think the best way to go about this, if you're an artist wanting to work with lab or lab designer wanting to work with art, is to try to familiarize yourself with both medias. So artists come and play a lot of labs to learn how this works. And if you're a lab designer, you can go and participate in a lot of interactive theater, or see a lot of dance, or whatever artistic discipline you want to work with. To get the sensitivity about how both works, medium works, so you can later know how to connect them. And I hope that a lot of more people will come and do this, work in this field in between, because I think there's a lot of potential there. And the more we work with this, the more tools we develop, and the more knowledge and sensitivity we develop, and that will enable us to make meaningful and amazing experiences for both labers and audience members. Thank you.